Greetings and love and kindness, family. I'm Karen Khadijah Davis-Foulks, the one and only Conscious Self Healthcare Educator and host of the Conscious Self Healthcare Conversation Radio Show. Every Wednesday from 4 p.m. to 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, 1 p.m. to 2 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. Community, this is your time to share your wellness stories and how you move from disease care to conscious self healthcare. I want to hear your story. We want to hear from you. Join the conversation each Wednesday. Call in and share how you shift out of chronic disease care stress right here on innerlightradio.com, the healing frequency. This is Dr. K, and I am looking forward to our conversation. So call in and share. Health is consciousness, and healing is a function of consciousness. Come on, family. It's time to rock the world with the new frontier of conscious self-healthcare. While I share my wellness story with you right here on innerlightradio.com, the healing frequency. Take that deep breath with me. Are you taking that deep, 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 deep breath with me? Are you dancing to the beat? Physically, mentally, consciously, move that body, take those deep breaths, feel it. Move that body. Are you taking those deep breaths, family? Did you take them through the week? You know it's time to tune into yourself. Ah. I'm feeling good. Are you feeling good? If you're not, tell yourself you are. Moving that body, taking that deep breath, you know how to do it. Ooh. Dancing with me. It's February the 5th, 2020. Taking that deep, 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 deep breath. Saying this is my time. This is my hour. I get to sit back and tune into myself while I hear some information that just may inspire me to do something different. Like become my own wellness doctor. Like taking the time to tune into myself and listen to my own vibrations. What I'm saying to myself. Taking that deep, deep breath. It makes you feel good. Definitely when your muscles loosen up from your own breath, you know you're taking a deep, 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 deep breath. Thank you, family. Thank you, community. Thank you for tuning in and sharing this broadcast with a friend. This is the Conscious Self Healthcare Conversation Radio Show. And I'm your host, Karen Khadijah Davis-Foulks. I want to thank you for coming aboard my friendship train this Wellness Wednesday, 2/5/2020, right here on InnerLightRadio.com, the healing frequencies. So you went in the mist. So when you are within the mist of healing frequencies of vibration, and you know what's being sent out. You know the wave format that's being delivered, and you come on board because you want to get into alignment with that good frequency, because your body will align with it if it's within those frequencies that it needs. It'll match up to it and aligned up with you, and it just may shift your energy to make you feel better, to make you feel good. And that's what life is all about. We're going to have some ups and downs, you know, like that train ride sometimes. But what we got to do is bring ourselves back into alignment each and every time. So take a deep, deep breath with me, and we're going back in time just for a moment. 1/5/2015, heart-to-heart healthy living. First, I give thanks for the creative source of the universe, and I give thanks to my mother, Shirley Hardy. Greetings, greetings to you all, and love and kindness. Thank you for tuning in and for sharing the good news from this show with family and friends. You are tuned into Heart to Heart Healthy Living with your host, Karen Khadijah Davis-Foulks. They call me Dr. K. I'm a pioneering Nest Health Wellness Specialist, bioenergetic bioinformational medicine, and a conscious self-health care educator. I'm not a medical doctor of disease care, but a pioneering educator in the field of quantum health and healing, having you become your own wellness doctor. Right here on the airwave of Inner Light Radio, the healing frequency, every Wellness Wednesday, you are listening to a live frequency, energetic broadcast today. I'm the founder of the Arc of Self-Healing and Self-Help. And where is it located? Each and every one of you have your own Arc. Self-healing, and you self-health education for longevity and peace. It's a health wellness maintenance organization for the prevention of disease care. We share information that illness are no longer seen as diseases. We now understand that we are correcting cellular malfunctions. Cells can malfunction because of various reasons, and that cannot be corrected by pharmaceuticals. It's a temporary measure, at the most, at least. An unnecessary removal of organs or any amputations of any limbs. The current paradigm in healthcare, the disease care model, is now seen as outdated and no longer a valuable way to care for the well-being of the human body. They said that the current paradigm in healthcare, the disease care model, is now seen as outdated and no longer a viable way. Can you sit back and take a deep breath on that and say, I've been wanting to release that thought. I wanted to let that thought go away, but somebody told me that that was crazy, that we create diseases. And I said, no, because if some people can correct them, it must be something. A cellular malfunction, that sounds good. Cells will malfunction. Why? Let me take a look at that scenario and see what's going on. Often it's in the semi-breakdown that the greatest breakthroughs are born. They said it's in the seemingly breakdowns that the greatest breakthroughs are born. Diseases are recognized as scrambled information. Y'all know when we don't get some information correctly and it takes us down the wrong path and we made the wrong turn because they forgot to tell us that it was a little pathway that you had to make a little slight right on. You know what I'm saying? So the information is scrambled and the cells don't know what to do. So we got to understand and know that, that there can be distortions in the human body field, because we have now understanding that every cell has a field that vibrates information out and in, signals. And sometimes it can get distorted because of scrambled information, a breakdown in physiology, how things are being process. And also, as part of a belief system, what would you believe in, the psychosomatic understanding that you have about what's going on in your life? Woo! Created by the ways in which you choose to care for your human body. You got to become your own wellness doctor, because if it's not in alignment with you, your true alignment of your conscious self, it's not going to work. Because you got to get beyond and know that it's not in the genes. It's not in the genes. They don't just turn themselves on and off by themselves, stay one way. And it's now the genes are taught to express themselves. Been that way for a long time. We just become in alignment with it. Past a couple of decades, individual people are beginning to become more and more in line with it. Family, community, and friends, set back. You're tuned in Heart to Heart, Healthy Living, the Conscious Self-Healthcare Conversation Radio Show. I'm broadcasting live from Washington, D.C., Anacostia, Southeast. Oh, how the nation capital have changed. If you haven't been in Washington, D.C. for a long time, when you come in and come downtown, uptown, low town, southeast town, northeast town, northwest, southwest, it all then changed around. But you know what? The heart and spirit of D.C. will always be what it is. So are you ready, family? Are you really, really, truly ready, family? Are you ready to bury disease thinking? Stop looking at yourself as being diseased. It's time to let go of that thought. Are you ready to shift from the man-made mindset? Are you ready to shift from the man-made mindset of human consciousness about how to look and think and care for your human body? Let alone your energetic body. They don't even want to talk about that. That's woo, woo, woo. That was a good song, too. So you never know. Got to really, really sit back and think about it. Are you ready to get radical? Are you ready to just get a little bit of radical to your family and to your friends and say, look, I'm going to venture in this new thing, this new but old ancient thing, and I think I'm going to become my own wellness doctor. I'm going to learn me some anatomy, some physiology. I'm going to understand the mental, emotional, the physical, the spiritual side of what's going on with my body. I'm going to stop, and I'm going to step back, and I'm going to take that view. Mental observation view is essential for self-success. So I can go back and look at when something happened, or when my body feels a certain way, or when I get a signal and I get something, symptoms of something that's trying to tell me something. I can match it all up because I've been paying attention to the whole big picture of who I am as this holographic image. Y'all know what I'm talking about, don't y'all? Health is consciousness, and healing is a function of consciousness. On this show, we share information, inspiring conversation, music, poetry, enlightened articles. We do interviews, and we hold the space with that breath. We hold the space for you to share your transformation self-health care stories. Are you ready, family? Are you ready to start sharing your wellness stories with me? Are you ready to say how you did it holistically, energetically, consciously, quantumly? You made that leap of faith. You tuned into yourself. You took the knowledge that you have, and you said, I'm going to do this differently. I'm going to do it consciously. I'm going to do it energetically. You know, that's how I opened up the show in 2015. The energy was working this week, family. You know, I was having them issues with the stomach, what was going on. And I said, there got to be something in the universe trying to tell me about emotions. Because physically, mentally, I'm aware, I'm getting everything done. But then y'all know the stomach turned on and it came back around. And I thought the ulcer came back. And I'm like, why the skin? What happened? Why did the covering come down? And I said, it's not physical. So what is it? It's emotional. I had to delve and find and see what needs to come up, what was trying to show me. And it did. Through somebody else, doing some other work, looking at some other stuff, went back to 2015. And all the information was revealed and made even clearer. It was like it was just a line. You know how the arrow's going point, 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 this way, keep going this way, keep going this way. And when you get there, stop right here. And all the information lined it up. And then this came out. So look, this is 2020. And I'm still sharing the same information the same way. Becoming your own wellness doctor, tuning into yourself, knowing that you are more than just your genes, that energetic field of vibration is really true, and it's the governing factor of this physical body. And that's why you know how we say it and how we do it every week. We're talking about love, how much you love yourself, self-love, self-care, self-worth, self-respect. That's what we're talking about, self-knowledge, having that self-assurance, feeling good about self, because why? You're doing it from your own understanding and you feel good about it. It's just like taking a deep, 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 deep breath and feel your whole body relax from that breath because you're all in tune. Everything's in alignment. The laws of vibrational energy, the best love in the world, is the power that brings your entire life together. It heals, renews, restores, and empowers you and me with divine energy and life. The breath of life for this human body. Yes, right. Connected to the energetic body. That's right. Pure energy of the breath. I'm love in action. You are love in action. No matter what it looks like, the world is love in action. I'm a master of positive self-expression. You are a master of positive self-expression. You have to know that for yourself. And that we are here to be givers and receivers of this divine love, the joy, laws of vibrational energy. And you know what I'm talking about. You know what I'm saying. You know how I feel about the one and only of Reverend Ike. And that's what this is all about, being Reverend Karen Khadijah Davis, folks. I do all that in the name and the process and the information that was shared by Reverend Ike through Thinkonomics. That's how I work with your family all the way around in every area. Thinkonomics is a way of thinking that gives you the opportunity to learn the truth about yourself. Don't get mad when I don't sit back and give you all the answers and go over everything and say, well, what do you think about this? Well, how are you relating to it? Well, I'm calling you for the answers. No, you're not. You're calling yourself for the answers when you call me. And I'm going to help you tune into yourself because it's about Thinkonomics. It's a way of thinking that gives you the opportunity to learn the truth about yourself. Y'all know the adage. You know the divine saying, be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, your awareness. But you got to be aware of what you've been thinking, how you've been feeling, what you've been doing, how you've been tying it in. You got to see the whole picture. You got to come into alignment with yourself in order to correct what you see going on in your life, physically, mentally, spiritually, emotionally. You got to look at it all. Yes. You can't leave it out. You got to have the complete alignment in order to transform and move and change the vibration and the frequency of things. You got to be able to do that through positive self-awareness, self-love, self-care, self-respect, self-knowledge, self-assurance, all through self-awareness. The individual can change the conditions and circumstances in his or her own life, mentally, physically, nutritionally. Why? I say one more time, why? We got to love our ancestors. We got to love those that came through planet Earth that did some great things here and made some shifts. And then when they went on to become ancestors, like Reverend Ike, all the information comes down and it just permeates all over you. And you're like, what's going on with me? I'm changing. I'm doing something different. I'm not like I used to be. I'm not like everybody else. Maybe something is wrong. Maybe something is great. Maybe you finally figured it out. And if you heard this statement from my ancestor, Baba Tomorrow, maybe that's why you're shifting everything. Because growing old does not make you sick. He said, growing old does not make you sick. It's growing sick that makes you old. Baba Tomorrow of Common Sense Herbs, our ancestor. I have seen no statement from no human in these modern times as great as this one. Growing old does not make you sick. It's growing sick that makes us old, and we got to understand that we would have cellular malfunctions. Things would occur mentally, physically, nutritionally, and emotionally. It's not to let that to be your guiding factor. We age every day, but it doesn't mean that we age in a certain way. It's how we're thinking and caring for ourselves. Taking a deep, deep breath. Honoring who you are. Being in tune with yourself. Being thankful. You know, on the show this year in 2020, if you care to, if you'd like to, you can email your questions or comments to innerlightradio@yahoo.com during the broadcast show. I will get it. You can call in and share 310-928-7733. You know, I'm not here to answer any questions about take this with this and take this with that and how do you think about this. If you want to share your wellness story, a little bit about what you're doing, come on, talk a few minutes, and then we can schedule time where you can host with me and share your whole story. So if you'd like to call in, make a little quick statement about something positive to help people shift their energy and move forward, 310-928-7733. You know, you must mute your phone. You are entering a live chat room. And I will invite you to join the conversation by your name, Skype name, or your phone number. Thank you, family. Thank you, family. Thank you, community. Thank you, friends. Thank you, listeners. Welcome to the Conscious Wellness Checkpoint. This is your checkpoint. We're talking about becoming your own wellness doctor. This is the Conscious Wellness Checkpoint for you to take a look. You see, now's the time to check the pulse. We're talking about the pulse of your thoughts, of your consciousness, of your actions. What you're saying, what you've been holding on to. It was not leading you to where you want to be when it comes to health care. Because you can become your own wellness doctor. There's no mystery and nothing is mysterious when you focus and align and put everything together. So you see, I have one goal. I have one purpose, one thought. I take one action, one vision, one movement. I got one passion, and that is to share information to empower all to rise above the fear of diseases and know what they truly are. It's time to embrace it. Embrace the understanding of the name. Be thankful for the name, what it shows you. Embrace the fear of diseases. Don't worry about them. Don't be concerned about them. Understand about them. Time into your understanding of anatomy, physiology, pathology, quantum health and healing. It's time to give disease a big hug, family. It's time to say, yeah, thank you for the name, but it doesn't mean anything negative. It holds a good positive vibration to me. It tells me exactly where the cellular malfunction is, the pathway of what I've been doing, and I can understand how I can correct it. Because they say that there are emotions and feelings and words that go with every organ. So it all can be matched up if I think about how I'm thinking, what I'm saying, and what I've been doing. So it's time to give diseases a big, big hug. Hold it with that deep, deep breath so tightly. And then release it as you let go of that breath and let it vanish. We are assisting each other with information so that we can make conscious self-health care moves. Mental observation view is essential for self-success. We're talking about making conscious self-health care moves. That's what I've done over this past month with the adjustment of my stomach and saying, what is it? What is it? It's not physical. We're doing it. And boom, as I said, it wasn't physical. A big shift came. So then they said, well, what is it? What are you holding on to emotionally that you thought that you released and let go that you understood? Because Karen, you process. You know the process. You do the process. So where in the heck was you not honest with yourself when you said, yeah, I'm going to do it that way. I got it. Then all of a sudden, something showed up. Bam. But Lisa, it was great. You was able to realize that it was in the emotional arena, the emotional field of things, what you had to look at again. And so, yeah, that was mighty. And you thought you had gotten over some things, but you realized one thing that's still there is going to always be there. And I had to come in alignment with that thought and with that understanding. And bam, for the past 5 days, well, strongly for the past 4 days, no fluctuation in the stomach, no volcano, feeling like boiling down the mountain. The stomach was on so much fire that I wanted to scream. My roommate wanted to shift energies and talk about, you need to go somewhere. No, I have to find out what it is. I'm my own wellness doctor. I got to be truthful with myself, honest with myself, go a little deeper, realize what's going on. You're the man in the mirror. You're only going to be as honest with yourself. You're never going to be that honest with anybody else. Unless they can read your energy. And then you don't have no choice but to be that way. But that's what I had to do. And I tell you, family, I'm feeling so good when you sit back and take the time. Because why? You relearn, you rethought, and you're rewriting your personal health care plan. And that's what I've been doing. And that's why I encourage you to emancipate yourself from medical mental slavery today. Take responsibility. Know what you're doing. Know on what's happening. It's like Reverend Ike said, you're the master of your thoughts and mind. He said, tell your mind what to think. He said, tell your feelings what to feel. Tell your body how to react. Master your mind. Master your feelings. Master your thoughts. Be in alignment. Don't be argumentative with yourself. Don't keep breaking yourself down. Listen to what self is saying to you. You must tell your holographic image what to do, how to act, and how to think. Let them call it what they want to call it. I call it making conscious self-healthcare moves. I say come and join the self-care revolution. It's time to become your own wellness doctor. And paying attention to your body's symptoms. It's a message in there. It's a message in there. They're telling you what to do. And anything and everything that I say to you, always remember this and know this to be the truth of everything. And this is how I always come back to realigning myself. And I don't get out of alignment too much. Not often. The only instrument, test, or evaluation you need to determine your state of well-being or state of health is your state of consciousness. No matter what you're going through, when you're going through it, what you call it, feelings, anxiety, worry, whatever you want to name it, is your state of consciousness. I'm here to tell you that for truth. The only instrument, test, or evaluation you need to determine your state of well-being or your state of health is your state of consciousness. It's going to match up with the thought, with the feeling, with the process of vibrating the organ is giving you condition. And when you understand your states of consciousness, like I just had to go through to see what was going on, why I was revisiting something that I thought had long gone and been checked and been put in check. States of consciousness. You got to always be aware of your states of consciousness when things are not in balance like you truly, truly want them to be. So family, I want you to step back and listen how I do that, how I read the human body feel, because nobody vibrates like you. You have a very unique signature that's governing of your physical body, so it's going to give you the information pertaining to you from the top down, from the in out, how you think. So understand what I do with the Nest Health Wellness Tools. Listen to my 3 commercials that's coming up. They tell you how we connect always. And bringing that body into oneness by me giving you this one view to see how you're vibrating through your energetic body to give you a better picture of what's going on. So sit back and listen to the commercials. Take a deep, 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 deep breath. Process some information for yourself as you tune into yourself. And thank you for tuning in to me today.
Do you feel lost?
Do you feel out of sync? Could it be that you are experiencing electromagnetic sensitivity? Yes, electromagnetic sensitivity. Could man-made frequencies interfere with cellular activity and melatonin production? We are beings of frequency, light, and information, and you are your own experience. Do not conform any longer to the patterns of man-made mindset of human consciousness. Be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. Schedule your NEST Provision Human Body Field Scan with Dr. K, 202-248-7749. Visit the website forcellife.com, the number 4CELLLIFE.com. Have the courage to expand your horizon and reprogram your cellular activities. Call Dr. K for your 15-minute wellness consultation, 202-248-7749. Is it time for a new approach to your health care? Are you ready to leave the dark ages of disease care management and pharmaceuticals? If your answer is yes, get ready to relearn, rethink, and rewrite your personal healthcare prescription plan with Dr. K. She is a certified anthologist and NEST healthcare provider, sharing the new science of information as medicine and cellular ecology. Did you know that the field of epigenetics states that you are more than just your genes, and those genes do not control your biology? Yes, that's correct. Schedule a Skype, phone, or office visit with Dr. K and get on board the friendship train to healthcare freedom. 202-248-7749. That's 202-248-7749. Visit us on the web, forcellife.com. The number 4, the words cell, CELLLIFE.com. Are you at your wit's end because there seems to be no solution to your healthcare problem? Is it okay for me to say to you that you can have peace of mind? Take back control of your health. Are you experiencing anxiety, arthritis, diabetes, cancer, fibromyalgia, high blood pressure, lupus, chronic fatigue syndrome, any fictitious disease? Whatever your symptoms or diagnoses are, there is a conscious solution to transform the cause of your pain. Not treat symptoms or mask it. No prescription medication, no over-the-counter drugs, no organs removed are required. Take back control of your health by the renewing of your mind. You can create wellness today. Contact Dr. K, 202-248-7749. Visit us on the web, www.cellcellife.com.
We gotta help family. We gotta help one another. We gotta help. And how do you help one another? By helping yourself. Health education for longevity and peace. Raise your information. Raise your understanding. Help. We can help one another by sharing some good information, some positive information with people. To truly step up to quantum health and healing and become your own wellness doctor. Once you learn anatomy and physiology and know what the doctor is saying to you, you'll realize a lot of times it's not as bad as it's saying. And when you sit down and you question them and you do that to them, they get totally upset with you because you see that there's no urgency to it. And they want you to have an urgency to it. And don't be a person that had to come back and forth out of emergency, because that's really when they really try to play them games on you. And because you don't know, and because you've chosen not to be aware or dig a little bit deep and understand a little bit more and stop thinking that you have got to have all these years of medical schooling to understand what's going on with you, when you just tune into yourself and be truer to yourself and be honest while you're having these feelings, and know that if it's caused through the mental, physical, or emotional aspects of your field and of your energy and of your life, you got to sit down and you got to pay attention. So we got to help one another. We got to be brothers and sisters to one another. We got to speak the same language of understanding.
understanding, generating peace and harmony and love with each other, and just feeling that vibration will make you be strong in what you do. And one of the ways you do that, you want to share positive information with the hashtag Black People's Comedic Boycott Ham. You want to share information around that hashtag to unite us as one, to let us have one common goal and one common purpose, to better each other's life, to make it easier for us. No matter where we are on planet Earth, we think in terms of sharing the good. We think in terms of harmony and peace. We think in terms of bringing true joy and understanding through the vibration of love. Laws of vibrational energy. You got to give it out to receive it. You got to be in alignment with it. You can't be against it in no way. When you're not in alignment, complete alignment all the way down, fluctuations happen and things occur. Then our body gives us symptoms to try to let us know what's going on. And because we're not really tuned into ourselves, we may miss a piece. The whole picture got to be there. I had to put the whole picture together, and I had to know and understand. It's not physical, because I know what I'm doing. I have healed from a stroke. I've brought myself back from the brink of not being able to almost eat, swallow, walk. So I know what's going on. I know that's intact. Why did my stomach burst like the volcano again? What was that all about? It's that part of that thing where it says you heal in reverse order, and sometimes you thought something that was healed through your energetic, vibrational understanding, not just the physical of what you've been doing, and bam, it shows up again. You know how they say, oops, upside your head, here you go again. And I had to think and make sure I understood that it wasn't anything new, that I hadn't totally cleared it up. And that's all I'm saying to you, family. That's how you become your wellness doctor. And with that tool that I use, that bioenergetic tool from Nest Health, to allow you to see what's going on energetically so you can understand the distortions and what's happening in your body, I'm telling you, there's no better tool out there. It's ancient wisdom. It's for us to come and be our own wellness doctor. Yeah, sometimes you want to talk to people and maybe I tried this route. Can you recommend what you think and you put it together? But for the most part, you got to know. And really, when you really know and when you're really honest with yourself, the solution is right there, and it always worked. Just like all of a sudden I was like, damn, how long am I gonna go through this volcano? And I'm like, Karen, you're not going through it long. I had to look at it and see it, and this one was a tough one for me because it was dealing with my mother, and I had to really come to a terms with it so I wouldn't keep getting this vibration, because that's how strong it was. And when it did come along and hit me, it was like a volcano erupting. And it's interesting that the volcanoes are erupting everywhere around the world. What's that about? What is Mother Nature trying to do and say? So, you know, you have your opportunity. I have a great affordable opportunity. If you're locally, it's more affordable for you. If you're a little bit away, you have to buy a device where I can work with you around the world to view your human body feel. So you go out to my website. Right, even with the videos on YouTube, I have the information down in the description boxes of how you can do this and get this at an affordable price. And I think once in your life, you need to step back and look at your human body feel and match it up with what you say you know and what you think you're doing. You know, then we have the max pulse where I have to see you in person. And if you really, truly want to know what's going on with your body, I mean, truly want to know what's going on with your body. And everything works from the nervous system. That's why they're always trying to shut it down. And that's why we got to keep that guardian angel with that deep, deep breath. The lymphatic system works with that nervous system. So the max pulse test that I offer you, I mean, it shows you everything that's going on. Even if your arteries are clogged up, your stress level, what's your frequency, what's your vibration, how it's being managed. Are you in a healing state or you're not in a healing state? What's going on? No better test. It's a test they use to give you a disease diagnosis. So why not use it to turn it around and see what's going on with your body and say it's a healthful thing? It's a healthful health thing to see what's going on. It's like that's how Ness turned that whole bioenergetic field on his head, because this model is not behind diseases. The Nest Health body scan is around an optimum body that's totally healthy. And you get to see where you out of alignment with total health. And then you know what to get to do well for mentally, physically, emotional, you know, every aspect of going on with your life. It's a perfect tool to match with the people that say they understand what's going on with their health and to be 100% certain about it. So take the time, schedule,
to use those tools with me, because you do not need a drug to live. You do not need a drug to heal. You do not need a drug to die. The body's intelligence knows how to live, heal, and transition out of the human form of all manifestation. It's time to emancipate yourself from medical mental slavery. Join me for the 10th year right here on Inner Light Radio. April 30th, we will be having a panel radio show again, getting the guests ready to come on and share with me. It will start on that Wellness Wednesday, the day before, the April 30th. And then it'll be a two-hour special broadcast from 1 p.m. to 3 p.m. right here on InnerLightRadio.com with our panel sharing with you. We'll see who will be the recipients of the Community Visionary Award, who will be the recipient of the Hidari Abdul Ali Conscious Self Healthcare Award, the Kavanaugh Russell Foulks Child Healthcare Award, the Shirley R. Davis Hardy Senior Weology Award, who has really sat down, transformed things, came with a new approach and understanding that growing old does not make you sick. Growing old does not make you sick. It's growing sick that makes you old. I mean, I love that statement from Barbara Timmer. I used to do it so much anyway. And now that he's an ancestor, I got to keep on saying it. I got to keep on saying it so we will understand what's going on and what we're doing. We got to tune into ourselves. We got to always tune into ourselves. You know, tune into yourself when you want to hear the truth, when you want to know the truth. You got to tune into your conscious mind, Heaven 101. You got to tune into yourself and not others. Once you get all the information, you got to tune into yourself and know it for yourself, and knowing that you're saying the right things to yourself, for yourself, to honor yourself, to help yourself, to move forward. Disease is a mistake in the body's information processing. That's why we call them cellular malfunctions. Because disease is a mistake in the body's information, physiological processing, what's going on, so we can call them cellular malfunctions. The cause is found in the biofield. Information is being blocked, distorted, incomplete, and so it's affecting the way your body functions at the cellular level. Disease is a belief system brought on by error thinking a way of the man-made mind instead of human consciousness. They want you to think that everything that's happening to you, organs get old and cells get old, and there's no way for them to rejuvenate themselves, and sometimes they got to be replaced. We can just take it out and we can just put you one in. Oh, they got the bionic kidney now. And look at all the millions of people that they set up on dialysis. And then they're going to say, we can leave your dead organs in your body because we're going to pull them apart. And we're going to put this man-made kidney in there for you to help you out. Come on, family. We got to think about what they're doing to us. Disease is a belief system brought on about error thinking. What you create in consciousness will manifest itself in the mind, and in the human consciousness will process it as truth. And that's why I said, what's going on? I'm doing everything correctly. I've been moving onward and upward these past 2 years. I moved up. I got my whole body back. I got everything together. I'm walking and talking. Why am I revisiting? What's going on? That emotional side of things, I'm telling you, family, it is something else. And if you get, that's what you really got to be tuned into, your emotions, the feelings, and what it's tied into when you're coming out to have something physically happen in your body. Forget about where is that and what's going on. Find out what is the connection, what is working together, and what you need to shift. All disease starts in consciousness, just as cellular malfunctions, thoughts do. To be free of diseases and cellular malfunctions, correct the error in consciousness. That's what I had to do. I had to correct the error. Take a deep breath.
Think about what you've been thinking about, what you've been doing, and where you are now. And are you ready to take that big picture so this April you can celebrate with us and say what you have done? Be a part of the wellness group on Facebook. Submit your stories. Start talking to me. I'm updating. Everything is still saying 19, but I'm getting to it. I'm getting closer to updating everything. If you want to find the secrets of the universe, I say family, community, and friends. If you want to find the secrets of the universe, our friend Nikola Tulsa said, think in terms of energy, frequency, and vibration. What is your energy output saying to you? What are you vibrating to? What frequency? How strong is the energy that you're putting out, that you're receiving, and what is it doing for you? If you want to find the secret of the universe, think in terms of energy, frequency, and vibration. Nikola Tulsa. If you want to learn the secrets of wellness, I said if you want to learn the secrets of wellness, if you want to learn the secrets of wellness to become your own wellness doctor, when things are going on in your body and in your life and in your thoughts, think in terms of healthcare as energy, frequency, vibration, and information and resonance. What are you resonating to? What is the information saying to you? How are you really feeling in the vibration? What frequency are you at? What's your energy output? You got to pay attention, family. You got to understand what's happening in your life. You got to know what you're doing. You got to take those deep, 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 deep breaths. It's time to match with the earth and the universe vibrational frequencies of life. You got to tune into yourself. You got to know who you are. So you don't want to have a war against yourself. But you want to think of the terms of war. With ascension, I rise. That prayer, that deep down understanding and knowing. Can we get that vibration going, Brother Jamal? Can we get a little bit of war going on? With ascension, I rise. You got to get that feeling. You got to feel it. You gotta let it permeate in you. You gotta take control. You gotta feel good about it. Can't let nobody turn you around. Raise your own vibration. Woo! Feel that. Get into the steam. You gotta work it.
Put them together, come on.
Paul. All that you know. Come on, well, stop. Yes. Shift your frequency. Change your vibration.
I got joy in my soul. God is in control. I got Satan on my trail. But I'm singing all is well. He's attacking every day. But I'm watching while I pray. This means war.
praise. No matter the attack, I will return back. Cause this means war.
Rise above it, fam.
This means war.
Rise above it all.
This means war.
Your own well stock.
This means war.
Pay attention. Was in the blood. So you got to not let them mess with your blood with these pharmaceuticals. You got to say no to these pharmaceuticals. It not only messes with the biochemical processes of the physical body, but it messes with that blood. And when you change the frequency of that blood, that vascularity is not correct. Things happen in the body. So, you know, when you're working on purifying that blood through that love and getting everything done right, fam, you got to be knowing what you're doing. You got to become your own wellness doctor. Nobody knows your body like you. Nobody knows what you're doing, what you're not doing, how you're thinking but you. And it's okay. Don't let nobody tell you that's stupid. You better go listen to a doctor. They know it all. It's a business. It is a big business. And it's such a big business that they are exempt from everything, even lying to you. Because it's not a lie. They say what they need to say to get what they need to get to have you do what you need to do. And that's why you got to know anatomy and physiology. You got to understand what's going on. You got to become your own wellness doctor. Stop messing with your blood, with these drugs. You got to think about what you're doing. All the way around. Yeah, everything shifts and changes and corrects itself, but you got to think about how it's coming back through that filtering system. You got the red blood, you got the white blood, you got the lymph, and you got the red blood, and they got to work together in harmony and peace. That's why I'm a lymphologist. I'm a doctor of lymphology. I teach you cellular ecology, that one field that they said, nah, we can't have no more lymphologists. We got to be able to cut them lymph nodes out. We got to be able to create catastrophic things in people's body so they think that it's mysterious, and it's not. That wellness system is in that breath, that lymphatic system, your immune system, that nervous system. It got to be in check. You got to send out the right vibrations, and only you can do it. You can put yourself in harm. That's why they say miracles happen every day. Something turn around because somebody got realigned with some truth, with some understanding. To become a powerful co-creator, the creator of your life, of your reality, we need to become conscious, integrated, and aligned co-creators. You can't just be doing one thing one way. We got to bring it all together. Most of us were never trained to understand ourselves or how to listen to our own bodies. Yeah, I'm an educator. Yeah, I'm a coach. And I ask people to tune into themselves. And when I hear that statement, they talk about, well, we got to train them and we got to do this. My mother used to always say, you train animals. You don't train humans. You're showing, you raise. I ain't got to train nobody. I want to give you some information. I want to help you through the processing of understanding and find out where your blocks are, what's stagnated in your mindset, and not letting you understand that you can become your own wellness doctor. Nobody can train anybody to anything because they can break that entrainment. The same way they think they be training wild animals to work in the zoo, and all of a sudden the animals turn on around and start biting the one that was feeding them. Oh, but what was it really feeding them? You got to think about it. You got to think about it, family. You have the power. And that's all I'm saying to you. It's tuning to yourself. So true energetic alignment, in order to manifest health and affect anything, including money, career, relationships, energetic alignment is needed between the body, the psychic, and the heart soul. It is the healing state, or some people call it the flow state, the ease state, body, psychic, mind, emotions, heart and soul, in and out. It all got to be in perfect alignment, and you can do it. I just showed you. I did it. You got to sit back and be your own wellness doctor. You got to process through your own self. You got to know when it's not physical. You got to know when it's not just mental, spiritual, emotional. You got to know where you need to expand in those areas and realign yourself. When we are disassociated and function only from the mind, disconnected from the creative power of our emotions, our heart, and unable to understand the messages. It's the symptoms are messages our body is sending to us. It creates a tremendous amount of anxiety and stress in our lives, which is damaging for the human body. And you can adjust that by being honest with yourself and coming to dance with me and be your own wellness doctor. Connect with me any way you can. Keep on trying. If you've been trying and you haven't gotten through, keep on going. The veils are being lifted. Things are coming down. It's going to be a way to reach me. The press release for Emancipate Yourself from Medical Mental Slavery Day is coming out. We'll have that GoFundMe page up. We have the page on my website, ConsciousSelfCare.com, ConsciousSelfCare.com. Reach me there. Reach me on Facebook. Connect with me. Help me spread the word to join us in the celebration of Emancipating Yourself from Medical Mental Slavery Day. And thank you, family. Thank you for coming to dance with me and breathe with me. And sit back this weekend. Massage your own feet. Do a self reflexology on yourself and see how powerful it is and see where you're tighter in your body. We'll talk more about reflexology, self-care with your feet next week. Have a great week. Take them deep, 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 deep breaths and tune into yourself. And remember the power of thickenomics. Woo! Riding the friendship train. Woo! Wow, family, that was a great show. I want to thank you so very much for tuning in to the Conscious Self-Healthcare Conversation Radio Show right here on Inner Light Radio. It was a pleasure having you tuning in. Now, you must tell a friend to tune in. And if you haven't called in and shared your wellness story, don't you think it's time that you help somebody with your wellness story? Call in, share your story, join the conversation. I'm Karen Khadijah Davis, folks, and I invite you to visit my website, ConsciousSelfCare.com. Or you can just go to the number 4, the word CELLLIFE.com. Leave me some information. I would love to talk with you. And once again, I look forward to you joining us next Wednesday right here on the Conscious Self-Healthcare Radio Show. It's a conversation where we uplift each other, where we share our wellness stories so we can help someone move from disease care to conscious self-healthcare. Thank you for tuning in. I look forward to hearing from you next Wednesday.